Feel good tonight, Lord.
Amen. Praise God.
Praise the Lord. Good to be in the Lord's house tonight. I believe I've already been to church.
Yes.
I've already heard enough to get my heart pumping a little faster than it normally does.
Yeah.
I've already felt the hair stand up on my neck tonight. I've already felt His Spirit.
Yes.
Praise God. That's what I come for, Brother Mike.
Yes.
With the way this world pushes you around, sometimes throughout a day, you just don't have time to do that. You never know what you're going to face. But what I heard tonight is, and I'm not going to preach on this, I don't guess, but God's able.
God's able.
That's what I heard in everything. God's able. There's things in my life that maybe I've wrestled with for a long time. God's still able.
Yes,
but God can handle those things. And if I could just give it to Him and leave it with Him, I believe He's able.
Right.
I'd like to leave it with Him tonight, wouldn't you? And I do thank everybody for your prayers. Usually in the beginning of, or at the end of every one of my classes, Sister Dana, I'll look at them and I'll say, thank you for your patience. And they'll look at me like,
yes.
What's that mean? Well, I like to say that when I first start off tonight. Thank you for your patience.
Wow.
I don't know if I'll teach this or preach it or, Lord, teach it or preach it. I don't know how it's going to go, but I know it's been on my heart. I've tried to get away from it, and He keeps bringing it back to me. Anybody who could preach or is called to preach could preach this every time, and you'll never get to the bottom of it. So little old me is going to jump in head first tonight, and we'll try not to drown together. But I love everybody, and let's see what we can get from this. It's encouraging. So let's read in the book of John chapter 20. All these scriptures will be very familiar to you, but I don't know that I've ever heard them brought in together the way the Lord's give these to me. But as soon as I deliver this baby, Brother Ronnie, it belongs to everybody.
That's right.
It don't belong to me no more. Yeah. We've talked about it before. When you start, the Lord gives you a thought, and you same way with y'all. You dung about it, and you work on it, and then when you get it right when it's ready to deliver, you bring it and you give it away.
That's right.
No other thing will you ever give the baby away as soon as it's born every single time. So this belongs to you after tonight, so it belongs to the Lord anyway. So in John chapter 20, we'll start with verse 24. Now I was going to read this a little, but I'll go a little bit further than what I first thought. And this is talking about Thomas here. He's already appeared to those, and they came to Thomas and told him about it, and John chapter 20, starting verse 24, says, "But Thomas, one of the 12, called Didymus, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said unto him, We have seen the Lord. We have seen the Lord. But he said unto them, Except I see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger in the print of the nails, and thrust my hand into his side, I will not believe. And after 8 days again, his disciples were within, and Thomas with them. Then came Jesus, the doors being shut, and stood in the midst, and said, Peace unto you. Then said he to Thomas, Reach hither thy finger, and behold thy hands, and reach hither thy hand, and thrust it into my side, and be not faithless, but believing. And Thomas answered and said unto him, My Lord, my God. I'd like to stop right there, and let me just go ahead and pray one more time before we get started here. Heavenly Father, as I come to you tonight, God, I pray that you would take this, do whatever it is you have intended to do tonight, God. I pray that you take this message, Lord, this stammering tongue, this weak mind, this broke body, God, and I pray that you'd use it for thy glory, that they would see thee high and lifted up on that cross of Calvary. In Jesus' name, we thank you and praise you. Amen and amen. As I go back to, and I read this, and many times I've thought about this kind of thought, but never really felt like I would try to preach on it. But in verse 25, he said unto the, unless I see his hands. I'd like to preach to us tonight the hands of Jesus Christ. The hands of Jesus Christ. As I started to pray about this and started to seek God's face, it just seemed like he took me back to a time when he was thinking that it was deciding that he needed somebody to be a counselor to man. He needed somebody to be an intercessor for man. He needed somebody to be a mediator. He knew that man was a fallen creature. He knew that man was going to need a father. He knew that man was going to need a brother. Man was going to need a sister. And I could see that hand reach up. And he said, I'll go, Father. He said, I'll die for Mike Smite. He said, I'll die, praise God, for Donnie Melvin. He said, I'll die for Ronnie Matney. I'll go, even though they'll spit on me. I see that hand raised and say, I'll go, Father. I'll go do what it is you need done on that earth. Because you see, I love them. They don't know me yet. But I want to raise my hand. Praise God, I want to volunteer that I'll go and lay my life down for Dennis Gobble. Praise God, he don't like me now. He don't want nothing to do with me. But one day he's going to come to me and he's going to say, that's the one, praise God. I'm going to follow that man right there that one day he raised his hand and said, I want you. I I want to give my life to you. Hallelujah. Praise God. The Lord of glory raised his hand and said, I want to give it to you, Madison. I want you to have my life. Yeah. Praise God. I want you to live through by me. Yeah. And I'm reading by his hands. I'm going to point to you a few times in this Bible, the hands of Jesus Christ. Right. What do you know about his hands tonight? Yeah. What do you know about the hands of Jesus Christ? Praise God. I know, and I'm reading the book of Ephesians, says we are his workmanship created in Christ Jesus. Now let me ask you something. I'm looking at a lot of working class people. How many of you with a show of hands has had a callus on your hand before?
No.
How many had a callus? Let's remember what caused that callus. Praise God. What caused that callus was working something continually, and it came up on your hand.
Wow.
Let me ask you one more question. Have you ever put a callus on the hand of Jesus Christ? Have you ever caused him to have a callus on that hand? Has he had to work with you? Has he had to mold you? Has he had to go back and mold you the same way? When that potter molds it a certain way, when he's done with it, it ought to be done. I don't believe he'll ever be done with me, Brother Mike. Praise God, he's still working on me. His hands are still working on me. And it all started when he raised that hand. He said, I'll go for him, praise God, and I'll work on him. They're my workmanship. I don't care how much pain they cause my hands. Praise God, we bruised his hands. We bruised his body. But he still said, I'll go. If you asked him today, I believe he's still raising his hand, saying, I'll go for that one. Praise God, I'll go for that one. My hand's still raised. I'm never going to lay it down, praise God, until it's time for me to come back and take my bride. His hand's still raised tonight. You believe that? I don't believe when he was finished, his hands went down. I'm going to show you where he raised them multiple times. Yeah. Praise God. And God about to be our helper tonight. He raised that hand for you.
Yeah.
Let's look in Matthew chapter 18. If you go with me tonight, pray for me. Praise God. I don't know where this is going, but I know we're preaching on the hands of Jesus Christ tonight. Yeah. Praise God. Way above what I can do, but let me bring you what I got. In Matthew chapter 8, verse 14. Matthew chapter 8, verse 14. And it says, and when Jesus was come into Peter's house, he saw his wife's mother laid and sick of a fever. And he touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she arose, praise God.
Yes.
Has his hand ever touched you and healed you?
Yes.
I'm here to tell you, I've been healed in this church.
Yes.
I believed in Jesus Christ. I believe he healed people.
Right.
But I didn't know he could heal me.
Right.
I felt the healing touch of his hand, praise God. If I die today, nobody will ever tell me or convince me any different. That's what touched my body when I was sitting in that seat. I felt like lightning bolt hit me in the back, and I felt my spine line up.
Praise God.
For you see, right before that, Sister Dana, I just took a voluntary layoff and gave up all my insurance for all my family.
Yeah.
And I thought, well, is this selfish or not, Donnie? Is this what the Lord really wants you to do or not? Well, right after that, my back went out, and the devil said, see right here?
Yeah.
You shouldn't have quit your job. You shouldn't have went away for the layoff. You should have stayed at work. Boy, that beat me down pretty hard, don't you know?
Yeah.
Couldn't hardly get off the couch. Come in here and thought, well, maybe these people got enough faith that they can believe that Jesus can heal me. Well, I'm telling you, when I came up here, I thought he could, but I really didn't put a whole lot of thought like I needed to. But when I sat back down in that seat, and I felt my spine like a man shook me like a rag, praise God, and I felt my spine align up, my back ain't hurt me since then. That was probably 5 years ago. And it was the faith of somebody else. You know what it came from? That healing touch. When he healed that and the fever left. Has his hand ever touched you and healed you? Praise God. I'm going to try to point to us many times tonight where he's touched people and healed them.
Yeah.
He's touched me and healed me of my physical ailments.
Yeah.
But that last week I was having some things going on. Who even knows what's going on in this body?
Yeah.
I ain't that old, but the older I get, I don't know what's going on inside of it. This hurts, that hurts. I'm thinking, man, will I ever make it to 60? Who knows, Lord? I'm just trying to make it on, Brother Mike. Just trying to keep going. That healing touch has touched this body. That healing touch has touched this mind many times.
Yes.
Brother Ronnie talked to us, preached to us wonderfully Sunday morning and Sunday night, but Sunday morning he told us about that new covenant.
Yes.
And I thought about that this morning. Praise God. It seems like the last 2 weeks when I wake up, the enemy's got a new bag of tricks for me. He's got a new bag of tricks. Praise God. He said, here, try this. Try this. Here, try it. You ain't done this. Things I ain't never seen before.
Yeah.
He tries to bring to me.
Right.
He's got new tricks every day.
Yes,
but you know what Brother Ronnie told us Sunday morning? It's that new covenant every day, praise God.
Right.
If that was the old new covenant, I'd done been lost.
That's
and
right.
Backslidden and probably burned in hell today.
Right.
But that covenant's new every day. I ain't trying to preach your message, but it encouraged me this morning when I was trying to pray on the way to work.
Yes.
When the devil brings new things to you, you don't even know where they came from.
Right.
Praise God, just remember, he told us there's a new covenant.
Yes.
Thank God for that healing touch of the hand of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Have you ever seen his hand before? Have you ever felt his hand before?
Yeah.
Amen. I felt it. What do we know about his hands today?
Yeah.
What do you personally know about his hands? Has he touched you and healed your body? If he hasn't, he can.
Yes.
Has he healed your mind?
Yes.
If he don't, I'm telling you, you're going to be in a world of hurt. Yes. If you're traveling around with this wicked mind,
yes.
Amen, Brother Donnie. Yes. If you're going around the things that the enemy wants to put in that mind, you don't have to.
No.
The Lord can touch it with his hand, praise God, and he can heal that. I tried to preach on the radio Sunday about that bruise that won't heal. You may have a bruise that won't heal, but Jesus Christ can come down with that hand and touch it, praise God. Not like these men that claim they got power. My God's got power.
Yes.
Praise God. There ain't no doubt. It's yea and amen. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. That's the God that I serve.
Yes.
I want to see his hands tonight.
Yes.
I want to feel his hands tonight. Yes. You know how I know when I feel his hands? It all goes back to having that compassion.
Yep.
You know what it feels like when God and Jesus Christ touches your heart? You love people that it's hard to love.
That's right.
And you don't want to see no harm go to them.
No.
And if you see them going towards something that's going to hurt them, you want to tell them.
Yeah.
I have a hard time getting along with you, but I want to tell you that ain't going to work.
Right.
Praise God. I want to see his hands tonight, don't you?
Yeah.
I want to feel that touch that I can go back to work tomorrow and say, you know what happened last night? I felt the hands of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Praise God, and I'm a new creature again.
Christ.
I was new yesterday, and I want to be new tomorrow
yes.
if I'm able to wake up from the hands of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Praise God. In Luke chapter 22,
Lord.
Let's go along with this and roll with it, see what he's got for us tonight. Luke chapter 22, starting with verse 49, says, when they which were about him saw what would follow, they said unto him, Lord, shall we smite thee with the sword? This is just another account of them coming to take Jesus out of the garden. And we know this is Peter that's going to talk about it. It says, one of them smote the servant of the high priest and cut off his right ear. And Jesus answered and said, suffered ye thus far? And he touched his ear and healed him. I got to praying about this. And you know what I seen in this? I saw a church member hurting somebody.
Yeah. Yeah.
I saw a church member hurting somebody.
Right.
If you've gone to church long enough, you've been hurt by the church.
Right.
You ain't been hurt by Jesus Christ,
no.
yeah.
but you've been hurt by the church.
Yes.
What was the first thing the Lord did? He took his hand.
Yeah.
He had to touch him. He put his ear back on.
Yeah.
I don't think he said abracadabra.
No.
Praise God, I think he picked it up.
Yeah.
I think he placed it on his head, don't you?
Yeah.
You think that changed that man?
Oh, yeah.
If the church, praise God, will come and hurt somebody, all you got to do is come back to the Lord.
Yeah.
The church is going to keep on hurting. That's just what they do, praise God. That's what the religious world does.
Yeah.
There's times I may hurt you. I don't mean it.
No.
I promise you I don't mean it because
wow.
I've been hurt before.
Wow.
You know how you don't want to hurt somebody else? When you've been hurt before.
Yes.
That's what I always tell anybody that's had something happen to them, a young person, old person. You know how it feels when somebody turns their back on you? Don't ever turn your back on somebody else.
Because
right. you know what it feels like.
Yeah.
You may be here tonight. You may have been hurt by the church 40 years ago.
Right.
It may still be hurt. Jesus Christ can take his hand
right.
the same way he took that ear and put it back on. I believe it's better than it was to begin with.
Right.
I say if that man lived 1,000 years, he never needed a hearing aid in that side.
Right.
I believe that.
Amen.
I believe God healed it.
Yes.
Praise God from the inside out.
Amen.
He placed that thing back on it.
Yes.
Through the hands of Jesus Christ. You believe that?
Yes.
I believe he touched it.
Yes.
Has he ever touched you?
Yes.
Praise God. Have you been down in the muck and the mire and he reached way down? Praise God and picked you up? I know he's picked me up, Brother Mike. I know where I come from. But he said, I'll come to you.
Thank God.
I'll touch you with my hand. I won't even put a glove on.
Yeah.
Right. There's a lot of things I like to put a glove on
yeah.
where I handle it. You know what I'm talking
yeah.
about? Praise God. He didn't do that.
No, he didn't.
He said, take that off. I'm going right to it.
Yeah.
I want to touch the hurt tonight. Yeah. Praise God. If you got something hurting you tonight, Jesus Christ wants to touch it.
Right.
I can't do nothing about it. But I can tell you who can. If you're here tonight and you got something bothering you and you don't need to tell nobody, that's what I like, Sister Dave.
Yeah.
We don't have to tell nobody.
Nobody.
If the Lord puts it on our heart we want to tell somebody,
yeah.
that helps us too.
Yeah.
But there's times and things I wrestle with, I don't tell nobody.
Right.
I love my wife, but there's certain things I wrestle with maybe she don't know about.
Yeah.
But right. Jesus Christ can heal that time and time and time again, Brother Dennis.
Yes.
When I go back to him and say, let me see that hand one more time. Let me see it. That hand is a form of identity.
Yeah.
When I was a young man, a little boy growing up, I could have spotted my daddy's hands through a million hands been pointed in front of him. I knew what they looked like. And the older I get, mine look less like what they used to, praise God. But that hand is a form of identity.
Right.
Thomas wanted to see that hand.
Yeah.
He knew when it was going to be. If he could only see the hand, he would have knew if it was the Lord's. Don't you believe that?
Yeah.
I believe he saw a lot of things when he walked with him. I believe he saw those hands heal these people.
Yeah.
I don't know how long he walked with him. I didn't study that part of it, praise God. But I believe he's seen a lot of things take place from the hands of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I believe he would have recognized it.
Yeah.
Can you recognize the hand of Jesus Christ tonight? Praise God. Can you recognize it? It's different than the world.
Yeah.
It'll point a different direction than the world's pointing you. Praise God for that hand. That's the only reason I'm here, Brother Dennis, because he reached down and touched me with those hands. Those clean hands touched this filthy body and this filthy mind and said, I can take care of that. You just give it to me. Praise God. If you got something you can't handle tonight, give it to him.
Yes.
He'll touch it, praise yes. God. He won't walk around and say, unclean. He'll say, come here. I can clean that up. He said, if thou wilt, thou can be made clean. He said, I will.
Yes.
Come here. I want to clean you up. Yes. I'm glad he told me that, Brother Mike.
Yes.
I'm glad he said, I'll clean you up. If he didn't, I'd still be in my sins. Just coming to church to eat hot dogs, praise God. But I come because of salvation.
Right.
I come to see Jesus Christ
yes.
high and lifted up
yes.
because it all started when he raised that hand.
Amen.
You believe he raised his hand and said, I'll go?
Mm-hmm.
I don't believe he had to think about it.
Mm-hmm.
I believe he said, I'll do it. I see how much it means to you and I want to do it. I love those down there and I know they need you tonight, today, praise God. And he raised that hand for me. Just for me, just for you. He raised his hand. Praise God. In John chapter 8, praise the Lord. John chapter 8, verse 4 through 8. He said, they said unto him, Master, this woman was taken in adultery in the very act. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned. But what sayest thou? This they said, tempting him that they may have to accuse him. But Jesus stooped down with his finger. You think he did that with his hand? You think he did that with his hand? What did he do with that? He brought conviction to a lot of people that day. That hand can also bring conviction to you. It can also point to something you don't need to be doing. It don't just always say, oh, let me come here and heal you. Sometimes it says, right here's the problem. When he stooped down, praise God, he didn't just write something silly. He wrote down something that convicted all of them.
Yeah.
He said, where are thine accusers? I said, Lord, I have none. They all walked away. They was convicted by something he wrote.
Yes.
That hand can convict me and heal me all in the same prayer. You believe that?
Yes.
Praise God, I know that.
Yes.
If it wasn't so, I'd just stay home. If all I felt was conviction and I never couldn't get past conviction, I'd just soon stay in the house because I'm going to be a miserable wreck. Because there's always going to be something that he can point to and say, how about working on this today? Or how about giving this to me today? How about let's look at this just a little bit? But he stooped down and wrote on the ground, praise God. How many times has he wrote on your heart? The fleshly heart, not on stone tablets, praise God, but he's wrote on my heart what he wanted me to do that day. And I said, Lord, I don't know about that. That's a little out of my comfort zone. But he took his hand and touched that and wrote down. Has he wrote on your heart today? Has he showed you something today? I don't know where you're at, praise God. You don't know where I'm at. I'm just giving you what he gave me. Has he wrote something on your heart today? Something he wants you to do? Something that don't belong? He was showing them something that didn't belong in their life. Obviously, they had some problems with trying to point this and wanting to twist him up. Praise God. Somebody wanting to twist the Lord up. They're going to have some problems pretty quick. Because you see, he's smarter than they are.
Yes, yes.
That's hard for some people to accept. Praise God. But I'm glad when he came down, he not only wrote on my heart and said, you need to change this, but he said, I can change it. You'll come from this hand that he writes with, and this one he'll heal me with. I believe that. Praise God. But it all goes back to him raising that hand. What do you know about his hands tonight? Have you seen his hands before? Have they touched your body? Have they touched your family before? Has anybody been healed in your family, Brother Mike? Have you seen healing in your family? Praise God. Has anybody seen healing in your own body? Have you felt healing in your own body?
Yes.
Brother Dennis, did you come back on your own or did he come back? Did he bring you back with his hands?
Yes.
Praise God. When you didn't know where you was at, praise God, he still had them hands on you,
yes.
didn't he? Praise the Lord. I'm glad of that, ain't you?
Yes.
I'm glad there's mercy in them hands tonight. There's grace in those hands tonight. If it wouldn't have been, Brother Rocky, we wouldn't be here. Thank God for his mercy. Day and day. If that mercy was from everlasting to everlasting. If that mercy quit, I want to die that day. Lord, take me home that day. Praise God, because I ain't going to make it tomorrow. Because I need thy mercy, and it all comes from thy hand. Praise God. In John chapter 9. Praise the Lord. John chapter 9, verse 1 through 6. And Jesus passed by and saw a man which was blind from his birth. And his disciples asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Jesus answered, neither hath this man sinned nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him. I must work the works of him that sent me while it is day. The night cometh, and no man can work. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. And when he had thus spoken, he spat on the ground and made a clay. How did he make that? put it in his hands.
Yes.
Praise God. He delivered the remedy.
Yes.
I want you to know he's delivering the remedy to you tonight.
Amen.
Whatever it is in your life, praise God, whatever it is you're wrestling with, whatever we can smile about, and it's all right today, but when you go out those doors, you're fighting with it again. You're
right.
In the same world I'm in.
That's right.
Praise God. Just because we're in here don't mean it's going to go away when we get out there, but if I give it to him, I believe it will.
All right.
He's bringing the remedy to you tonight, praise God, and it's on these altars.
Yes.
It's wherever you pray, praise God. You said, Brother Donnie said, and he read to us, you got the remedy, Lord. I'm asking for it. There's been times I've come to him and said, Lord, I've read where you're the God of peace.
Yeah.
And right now is a perfect opportunity for you to prove yourself to me.
Right.
Not that you have to.
No.
Right.
I came to him like that before, yeah. Church. I'm not being arrogant or bold, and God knows when my heart was spoke to him.
Right.
I said, God, I read it in your word.
Yeah.
Here's a perfect opportunity. If you're looking for somewhere to work today, I sure got a place for you to work, because
yeah.
There ain't no peace in my heart.
Yeah.
Praise God, I've got anger and this disbelief and all kinds of things that don't belong.
Right.
If you'd like to work on something today, I'm available for you to work on.
Praise God.
And then when you work on me, maybe I can work for you.
Right.
Praise God. He delivered the remedy. Time and time again, I read in here, he delivered that remedy. He didn't say, somebody else go handle that spit and that mud. He said, I'll do it.
Yeah.
He said, I want to show you something. I want your faith to grow right here.
Yeah.
Praise God. Don't you know he rolled it in his hand and he brought it to him. And oh my, I'm glad when he brought it to me, Brother Mike. He came and found me. See, I didn't want nothing to do with him.
Right.
Brother Dennis, he come and found me. I didn't come to church and say, hey, there he is. Praise God, he come and found me.
Mm-hmm.
He brought me to my knees and showed me what I needed was him, Brother Dennis. It wasn't nothing else in this world.
Yeah.
I said it many times. I didn't come through those doors just a happy man, just excited about everything. I was broken, Brother Dennis.
Yeah.
Everything about me was broken.
Right.
But he put all those pieces back together.
Yeah.
How did he do it? Did he send somebody else to do it?
Yeah.
Did he say, hey, if you'll send somebody else, and he can probably help them, and I'll pray for them? He said, no, I'll go.
Yeah.
I'll go, praise God. I'll deliver the remedy. I'll touch them, and I'll heal them of their infirmities, praise God, if they'll only come to me. What is it? It's hard for somebody to touch you when you stand at afar.
Yeah.
Can I come close enough within arm's reach tonight? Will you come within arm's reach of Jesus Christ tonight that those hands can touch you? I've often said you can't get something somebody else until you open your hand.
That's right.
If your hand's not open, you go and buy some food in the morning at the convenience store or something, and you give them some money. If you don't hold your hand out, you ain't getting change back.
Right.
I'd like to hold my hand out tonight and let him put his hand in mine.
Amen.
Wouldn't you? Praise God. I'd love to go hand in hand with Jesus Christ. What a day that'll be, Brother Dennis. One day I'm going to get to do that all day long, Sister Carol. All day long. And it's a day without end. That sounds like a day I'd like to have. No pain, no sorrow. I'm not even going to be looking for no pain because it ain't going to be there. Praise God. In John 19, chapter 19, verse 17. What do we know about this? It says, and he bearing his cross. How did he bear it? Praise God. He grabbed it with his hands. He grabbed a hold of your cross and my cross with his own hands. You believe that tonight? Praise God. You believe he died for you?
Yes.
I believe he died for me. I believe he grabbed that cross and said, I'll do this for Mike Smythe.
Amen.
For you see, right now, Mike don't know nothing about me. And then it's going to take him a little while. Some of us dogs are a little hard-headed than others. That's what a man told me one time. I said, I hate I waited until I was 26 to come after the Lord. And he looked at me serious and said, some dogs are more hard-headed than others. And he just kept going. I thought, what'd you say? You didn't tell me that. But it was the truth, praise God. But does that mean if you don't come by the time you're 26, he's done with you?
No.
If you don't come by the time you're 30, is he done with you? Oh, no. 31? No. No. I've seen him save those who were 75, 80.
Praise
I can remember my grandmother.
God.
She was a good woman, but she just didn't go to church. And when she was about probably 75, I wasn't even going to church at the time. I told her, I said, you need to think about going to church. I mean, you're getting pretty old.
Yeah.
And I said, it's always bothered me that you don't go to church, you know. And she said, well, I've been thinking about it. Here I was thinking that it was an age limit on this thing. They're falling off all different ages. You ain't got to be 75 or 190. Praise God. You're going to die when the Lord says it's time to die.
That's right.
And I want to be ready, don't you?
Yeah.
I want to reach out for his hand now so it's not going to feel funny when I try to reach out for it later.
Amen.
I want to know what it feels like today.
That's
I want him to deliver that remedy to me. Whatever you're wrestling with tonight, if you go home with it, it's going to be of your own doing.
That's
praise God, because he's given you an opportunity tonight to give it all to him.
Yeah.
I'm just pointing just the little things that he's done, but you dig about it and you can find what he's done with his hands from the front to the back.
Yeah.
What is that song they sing? He's got the whole world. In his hands. I can remember going to church very few times do I ever remember, but I remember that song when I could have been one 3 years old, but I still remember that song. He's got the whole world in his hands. You believe that?
Yes.
He's got Rocky Prater in his hands.
Yes.
You believe that?
Yes.
Hey, what about that? That feels pretty good, don't it? I like the way that sounds, don't you? Praise God, he's got Dennis Smythe in his hands. You like that? I like waking up knowing that, don't you? Praise the Lord, makes me want to live all day long, don't you? I like to go to work twice if I can feel that. I'll tell him, you know what? The Lord's got me in his hands today. What do you think about that? They don't know what to deal with that. I like when you walk up to them and say, Lord, been good to you today? And they go, yeah. You've been good to me.
Yeah.
Praise God, he woke me up. But you know why? Because I'm in his hands.
That's right.
Praise the Lord. He's got the whole world. Yeah. He's got the little bitty babies in his hands.
Yeah.
He's got you and me in his hands tonight. You believe that? Since he raised that hand in the very beginning. In the very beginning, he raised that hand. Praise God, that's the only reason we're able to be here tonight, Brother Mike. Praise the Lord. In Revelations, oh, we already read that one. Come to the music, if you would. Luke chapter 24. No, we haven't read that one. Revelations. Getting beside myself tonight. Praise God. I want to go to heaven, church, and I want you to go with me.
Amen.
I want to go with you. Revelations 1, 17 and 18. As I was praying about this, and it seemed like the Lord gave me this, and it really encouraged me. It said in Revelations 1 and 17, said, when I saw him, I fell at his feet as dead, and he laid his right hand upon me, saying unto me, fear not. This is John talking to him. Fear not, I am the first and the last. I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. Amen.
Amen.
And I have the keys. Where do you think he carried those at? I believe he carried them in his hands. Praise God. When he come up out of there, what did he have in his hands? He had the key. Praise God. He had victory over hell and death and the grave. You believe that? That's why I'm able to be here tonight. Praise God. He come to me. He saved my soul. He gave me hope, telling me he's already done something I couldn't do. I'm glad he's holding the keys, ain't you? I wouldn't want to hold them. Praise God. I didn't know. Flopping and losing them. I ain't good about having keys, but I believe he's got a hold of them keys. He ain't let go of them. The enemy like to make you think, praise God, that he's lost those keys.
Yeah.
But he ain't lost those keys.
No.
Praise the Lord. I'm glad he was able to go. He went in. Praise God. He came out victorious. No other person, no other man, being, or anything would ever be able to do that and to hold on to those keys.
Amen.
I could just see him when I was praying about this. I could just see him coming out with that hand raised. Praise God. He's showing what he had in his hands. You know what that means? Somebody just got beat up.
That's right.
How's he going to come get the keys to your house? They're going to have to whip you, ain't they?
Yeah.
Somebody just got beat up, Brother Mike, and he's still beat up.
Yes,
if I can keep him where he belongs, he's still beat up.
Yes,
but when I pull him into my realm and let him in the ring with me, you know what's going to happen? I'm going to get beat up.
Yeah.
Praise God. Go on and stay out there. I'm going to live on the victory that Jesus Christ got. Because I'll never get victory over the enemy without going back to that victory.
That's right.
You believe that?
That's
praise
right.
God. You try to get victory over the enemy, you're going to lose.
Yes. Yeah.
You're going to be miserable.
Yeah.
The best you'll ever feel is miserable. Praise God. But if I can take him back to that victory and say, look here, what happened here? This is where my hope is at. In the victory of my God and my Jesus Christ holding up those keys. Praise God. He can go and come whenever he wants. That's what happens when you get keys. You start handing out keys to somebody. You know what they're going to do? Come and go as they want.
Right.
Praise God. My Jesus comes and goes as he wants. And I'm glad when I reach out my hand, he can come into my heart.
Oh, yeah.
Praise God. Luke chapter 24.
Bless you, Lord.
Praise the Lord. Luke chapter 24.
Bless you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Luke chapter 24, verse 49 through 53. Luke chapter 24, 49 through 53 says, and behold, I sent the promise of my Father upon you, but tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem. This is after when he's getting ready to ascend, till you be endued with power from on high. And he led them out as far as Bethany, and he what? He lifted up his hands and blessed them.
Yeah.
Praise God. And what did they do after that? Let's read the rest of it.
Yeah.
That's what I want to read about. Praise God. He said, lifted up his hands and blessed them. And it came to pass while he blessed them, he was parted from them and carried up to heaven. And they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy and were continually in the temple praising and blessing God. Praise God. He raised his hands in the beginning. He raised his hands right here. And I believe there'll be another day when he raised his hands. We ought to be in the temple blessing him continually. Praise God. This is what they did when he left. Why have we stopped?
Yeah.
What changed, Brother Ronnie? What's changed between right here and right here?
Right.
It ain't nothing no different.
Yeah.
Praise God. He raised his hands and blessed them. Would you like for him to raise those hands and bless you again tonight like he did in the beginning? Praise God. I wasn't born then, but I've been born since that. Praise God. I've been born and I live for Jesus Christ. I want him to raise those hands for me tonight. God, would you bless me tonight with thy spirit, with the spirit of thy hands? Those hands have been a long way. Can you count the calluses on his hands for you tonight? Have you seen them closely? I believe he'll show them to you. He'll show you where he's been patient with you. He'll show you where he's worked with you, praise God. Time and time again where I found him in the same place with the same lure that the enemy's given to me. Praise God. And God said, bring him back. Jesus said, bring him back. I'll work on it just a little bit more. I know it's hurting here. You ever had a job that it starts to hurt and blood starts coming out? I believe I put blood on those hands before, praise God. I believe he's had to work time and time again. And it's hurt when he's had to wrestle with me. What happened to that potter when he was moving that wheel and that hard piece was inside of that?
Yeah.
He said, ow.
Yeah.
Yeah,
he
did.
That happened to his hands. How many times have I done that?
Yeah.
How many times have we done that, Brother Mike? But he said he lifted up his hands and blessed them. You believe he can still do that tonight?
Oh, yes.
I believe he can still raise those same hands tonight and bless me just the same. I wish he blessed you first. Do you know what's going to happen when he blesses you?
Yes.
If I love you the way I need to, I ain't going to go, well, how'd they get it?
No.
What'd they do any different? No. I'm going to lift my hands and praise and worship. I'll never forget this, and we'll come and pray. I've told it before, but it was such a leap in my walk of serving the Lord. When the service was going and wonderful, everybody was standing up and raising their hands and praising the Lord. And I was probably the only one in the church backwards, didn't know what was going on. Thought, well, they're having a good time. What's this? Yeah. And I was sitting there, and Sister Marie looked at me and said, you need to stand up and praise the Lord, whether you feel it or not.
Yeah.
I said, okay. So as soon as I stood up, you know what I felt?
Yeah.
I felt the same thing. I was ignorant. I learned, Brother Mike. I didn't even know what they was doing. So when I raised my hands and said, Lord, it feels good.
Yes.
I want to keep doing this, praise God. There's some people who don't want to raise their hands. That's all right. I like to raise mine, don't you? He raised it in the beginning. He raised it right here, praise God. And I believe I can raise them tonight for him, can't you? Let us come and pray tonight. God wants to bless you with something. He wants to deliver that remedy, whatever it is in your life, praise God. Can you see his hands tonight? Oh, Lord, bless his holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Have your way, God, have your way. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for my brother tonight, God. All the encouragement that he's given me, Lord. I thank you for his grace, Lord, that you've shown him. I thank you for his walk, Lord. Thank you for each and every one of my brothers, Lord, their dedication to thee. What an encouragement it is in the church, God, to see somebody who's got a made-up mind, Lord, how it encourages us many times when we get beat along this journey.